Hello friends, I am Dr. Navneet Sood. I am a pulmonologist in Dharamshila Narayana Hospital in Delhi. Today we are going to talk about a very prevalent topic, that is the effect of air pollution and its stimulants on the patients of COPD. COPD is primarily, as you all know, is a disease of lungs which is most commonly found in long-standing smokers and those people who are affected by smoke in their professions. Now, what happens is in the COPD, I'll give you a brief detail. In COPD, the lung architecture is as such quite damaged. The smaller units of lungs are damaged. There is lot of secretion production. There are lot of chances of infections getting to the patient off and on. Whenever the season changes, they have their increased symptoms and signs. What happens when air pollution sets in? Now, air pollution has two or three components. One is the gaseous components, that is ozone, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur gases, and the other is the particulate matters. PM 2.5, you must have heard it from all the media sources. Now, how does these things affect the patients of COPD? COPD lungs are as such quite sensitive to lot of infections and noxious stimuli. COPD exacerbation definition in itself tells the exacerbation is due to the effect of noxious stimuli, which can be pollution or an infection. Now, what happens when the air pollution and smog is there? The patient will have increased shortness of breath, wheezing, secretions, more of hospital visits, more of admissions, and sometimes increased mortality. The things which we can do to prevent these things in patients of COPD is that they should take proper medical care at the appropriate time. Do not wait for too long for the symptoms to get out of hand, specifically in the season where the air pollution is too high. So what are the things which we can do to prevent the exacerbations of COPD? One is basically, the first and foremost is stop smoking. The second is you can manage your outdoor activities according to the air quality index, which is frequently available in internet sources as well as in the media. If air quality is very bad on that day, you should avoid going outdoors completely. If the air quality is moderate to severe, still you have to avoid going in early morning and evenings where the air pollution is highest in the day. The third thing which we can do is use of air purifiers in your homes. Most of the COPD patients are elderly. They stay in the homes for a longer duration of time. So wherever they stay, they should stay indoors and use the air purifiers in their specific rooms where they are going to stay for most of the day. They'll not stop it completely, but it will help them overcome this effect of air pollution for a longer period of time. Keep your room properly ventilated, because indoor air pollution is also going to increase, and that will also be detrimental for your health. Avoid going on busy roads to avoid exposure to the vehicular air pollution. Use proper mask whenever you have to go. N95 is the recommended mask, which has to be worn by you, and this is a disposable mask, mind you. You cannot use it on daily basis, the same mask. Use it whenever you are going to go outdoors. The only problem with N95 mask is, over a period of time, as you have worn it for an hour or two, the resistance to inhalation because of the mask pressure is too high. So that in fact will give you a feeling of shortness of breath. You need to go to the medical professional as frequently as possible if required, because once the trigger of COPD exacerbation sets in, then you are very likely to get hospitalized or even go to an ICU if the condition go out of hand. The other things which you can do is properly get vaccinated. If you find having any pneumonia or any infections, you need to get proper antibiotics. For all these things, you need to consult a medical professional on timely basis. As you delay the things, it will get difficult for all the medical professional also to help you in these cases. In the end, I'd like to tell, please take care of your health, use simple precautions and vaccinations, and get the medical help as soon as possible whenever you are having some exacerbation of your symptoms.